Mm-hmm. Look at my pretty girl. This is my wife. She's so sexy. Shake it, shake it, shake it. All right, so the other sexy things that are here are the equipment that's here. So, what do we got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 pieces. I'm going to try and get these all on one load to go back. Not on one load, on 4 loads instead of 5 loads. I may possibly have to come back down and get that wagon. But I'm thinking that the older baler and the 7810 go together. The 7530 and the new baler go together. The 8530 and the stack wagon go together. And the 8120 and the bale wagon go together. The hay wagon go together, all on 4 loads. So that it's not so terribly expensive, right? And I'm pretty sure I can get them all on there. I mean, the 8120, I could just hook that right up to it and drive it right up onto the trailer. It's a 30-foot wagon, if I remember correctly. It's a 30-foot wagon. 40-50, that gives you 23 feet. I think we got more than enough room. Even if we just pull it up on there and then take the hitch off and shove it forward and chain it down, I think we can get it on. Pretty sure. Anyway, right, Teresa? Yeah. Oh, she doesn't like being on film, but she just breaks cameras left and right because of her beauty. All right, just snap.
Break them with my mustache.
Yeah, you're Asian Schwarzenegger. So pretty. Look how pretty she is.
You're gonna hear the roar of this engine here on this 550, but I want to take note. 90% of the people that are out here on YouTube world are complaining about rain, lots of it, every other day, including myself, because at home I have 3,700 acres of hay that needs to get made. Most for the first time, and some for the second time. But down here in North Carolina, down east in North Carolina, the corn is drying up, it's dying. It should not look this way. The ears should be here. This should be vibrant and green. Now I'm going to peel this back, and I know the Lancasters watch me here. I'm going to use their name because they're such great people. I tell you, I've never knew Southern hospitality until I met these fine folks down here. So here's the ear. It's in full dent. It shouldn't be this way. Now, I don't really want to get into it too much, but I guess one little ear ain't going to hurt. Look at the kernel depth. That's my fingernail. There's nothing here. These things are so small. When I got here, the corn was just tousling out, or just about ready to tousle out. And of course, they were in desperate need of rain then as well. Didn't get it, you know. And then all of a sudden, after a week of running, and it looked like the lower leaves on the corn were starting to turn, and I said to Teresa, I said, you know what, if they don't get rain in the next couple days, this corn crop is gonna be total shit. And you know what? By the grace of God, we got 2 inches. Then we worked for a couple more days, and we got 2 more inches of rain. And there it is. It tousled, it pollinated, but then it dried up again. In the last 3 weeks, we ran like hell. Baling straw, they cut the wheat, and I baled the straw, we baled the straw. One lonely farmer baling crew did, and other baling crews around did, and they did a phenomenal job. And it hasn't rained since. There was a little bit of a rain shower that came through about 3 days ago and just teased it a little bit, and it brought the beans took it on real nice. The cotton did as well, and so did the tobacco. But the corn, this to me looks like 60 bushel to the acre corn. I've grown a lot of corn in my life. I know a lot of people on YouTube land don't think that I ever did, but I did. I grew corn up until 2014, and then I quit because of deer and adverse weather conditions like drought all the time. And the corn varieties that we used to get, though they weren't high yielders, they were tanks. Those damn corn varieties would they had a pollination of a week and a half, not 4 days, like this stuff does here. Well, that's a septic system right there. I need to get around that the other side. I think Timothy parked the damn trailer right on top of it. But he made it out. Anyway, yeah, so The corn is pretty sad state. The cotton looks great. The tobacco looks incredible. The wheat crop was mediocre. The soybeans are doing okay. They just need rain. And I'm really tired because I just drove all the way from New Jersey this morning down here to pick up the wagon that I'm dragging behind me there. And I baled hay until about 11 o'clock, 11:30 last night. And now I'm headed back to New Jersey with this wagon. I've got lights on it. I've got reflectors on it. And I'm gonna try not to take the interstate because it's 70 mile an hour. I like the 60 mile an hour ones better, but we're gonna take 301 up to 58 and see how we make out there. At least that's the plan. Anyhow, I'll see ya on the flip.